In what used to be one of the busiest entertainment districts Kansas City had to offer, you'll find deep-rooted history. Nestled in between buildings sits the Negro Leagues Baseball Museum, filled with never-before-heard stories.
I tell my guests all the time, there's nothing sad about this story. Even though it is anchored against the backdrop of the ugliness of American segregation, a horrible chapter in this country's history, the story here is what happened out of segregation. This wonderful story of triumph and conquest, and is all based on one small, simple principle. You won't let me play with you, I create a league of my own.
In 1920, right here in Kansas City, Missouri, Hall of Famer Andrew Rube Foster established the leagues. Players with a passion to play baseball refused to take no for an answer. This would not only change the game, but spark a movement in American history.
It was with Negro League Baseball that African-American players found their greatest opportunity with traveling teams.
While Arkansas did not have an official Negro Leagues team, the state did have one of the greatest semi-pro teams in the nation, the Arkansas Black Travelers. Hot Springs also became a central location for spring training.
And they were coming down and taking advantage of the therapeutic waters of those hot springs. So teams like Kansas City Monarchs, Homestead Grays frequently trained in Arkansas.
Plenty of legendary players came out of the natural state, like Reese Goose Tatum, a first baseman who played for the Indianapolis Clowns, amongst other teams. A self-imposed color barrier lasting 6 decades would eventually come to an end.
It wasn't until 1947, with Jackie Robinson's integration into baseball, that black talent would forever change the makeup of the major leagues.
Very appreciative, very thankful.
It was players like Robinson who paved the way for future players like Arvis Harper, one of the first black Arkansas Razorback baseball players.
So when Hank and I went in, we knew the situation was similar, okay? And we knew because of Jackie Robinson, we knew the importance of our role.
The North Little Rock native says he couldn't have imagined what was ahead of him.
So I'd go into the outfield and, you know, all kinds of racial slurs, and they would be throwing stuff out of the stands. And, you know, I look up in the stands and they'd have these hangman nooses, you know. Oh yeah, it was pretty bad.
Still, he wouldn't let anyone stand in his way of becoming a Razorback. In 1978, he was drafted to the Houston Astros.
It's an opportunity, and that's all we ever wanted. It was an opportunity, and we got ours.